Hi, I'm Megan. Today we're going to do a saline agglutination test. In cases of immune-mediated hemolytic anemia, the body actually coats its red blood cells with antibodies, and then the red blood cells end up sticking together. This can cause big problems further down the road as far as inappropriate clotting. And it's an easy way for us to kind of the first step in diagnosing an immune-mediated disease. So it's very simple to do. You just need anticoagulated blood. So make sure that it's not fresh blood that you've just drawn from the animal without putting it in a tube, because you won't be able to tell the difference between clotting and agglutinating. So draw the blood, put it into a blood tube so it's anticoagulated to do your test. And then you just need some saline and a microscope slide. So I'm going to start here with my anticoagulated blood. And I'm just going to draw out a small amount and put a drop on my slide. Next, I'm going to draw a small amount of saline and then put a drop of saline on the slide. Next, I'm just going to take the slide and kind of rotate it back and forth to kind of mix everything up. The reason for the saline is that it can be difficult to tell the difference between rouleau and autoagglutination. If you see kind of a sandy appearance within your smear here, and you know, if you start to see cells clumping up, rouleau and autoagglutination will look very similar macroscopically. So the reason we put the saline on there is if it's rouleau, where cells are just kind of stacked on top of each other, we can see rouleau because of dehydration, and in some patients it may be normal for them. The saline is going to help separate that out. If the animal is truly autoagglutinating, the saline is not going to break up that autoagglutination. So I'm kind of rotating my slide here a little bit. I can actually see, you know, some clumping on here. So I'm assuming this is going to be a positive saline agglutination test, but always want to check it under the microscope. So I'm going to do this under 10 power, and what I like to do is just find a spot kind of towards the edge of the slide. You want to make sure that you're looking at a monolayer of cells, and what you're looking for is cells clumped together like grapes. I'll kind of get in here and take a look at this. So again, rouleau is going to look like cells stacked on top of each other, like if you were to take coins and stack them up. And autoagglutination is going to look like kind of clusters of grapes. So it's unorganized, just bunches of cells together. And in this case, I definitely see autoagglutination. Looking through the rest of the slide, I don't see any rouleau. If I did see both, I'm going to put a little bit more saline on this and check again, but that's how you do a saline agglutination test.